Hello, I'm the Budget Modder and this is episode 19 of my Copper State Models 132nd Caudron G3. If you're watching this, then please subscribe to my channel, give the video a like and ring my bell, that'd be brill. Thank you! In the last episode, we rigged the vast majority of the starboard wing, which took such a long time to do. So, to begin this episode, we'll be finishing off that rigging. So, without further ado, let's crank up the speedy uppy thing and crack on! There we have the starboard wing rigged in its entirety. It only took just over 6 hours. I'll leave this here for a moment to look at. I'm really happy with how that starboard wing rigging came out. Now, let's see if we can replicate that in the port wing. So, here we go with that rigging. And that's the port wing complete. Just under 3 hours. Less than half the time at a starboard wing. Right, let's have a look. Nice work. Well, sort of. On closer inspection, I noticed bends in both the rear cockpit struts. Bugger. They need fixing. So, I decided to snip the struts and remove about a millimetre to allow them to look straight. And then super glued them. So here we go with that. Here, I'm just making a support for the top wing so when I snip those, it doesn't all collapse and it keeps it in the right position. There we have those struts straightened. A good job there, I think. Well, past me seems happy about it. Anywho, time for more rectifications. The rudder cable. As you may remember, in a previous episode, I snipped the cable by accident. So, it's time to replace it. Here we go. There we have the cable repaired. Not too shabby a job. Next up, we can get on with the parts we still have to clean up and paint. That's the trim buckles for the wing struts and the supports for the tail. So, let's get them cracked. Right, we can pop those out the way, ready for painting. Now to glue the tail booms into place. It's starting to look like a biplane now. No, just you wait till you see how much rigging there is to do on those bleeding booms and tail. Anyway, let's get these fitted. There we have the booms connected. That was a pretty painless job, that was. And it really is starting to look awesome. Anywho, stop admiring your own work. Up next, we're going to remove and clean up the control horns for the rudder. So, here we go with those. There we have the horns ready for priming and painting. Now we can mark and drill a few holes in the tail section ready for rigging. As you can see in the picture in the instructions, there is a little bit of rigging to do on the tail. So let's get these holes marked and drilled. There we have the holes drilled in the tail sections and horns, ready for the rigging once we've fitted them. Now, let's get on with priming the parts we haven't done yet. I'm using Mr. Surf's 1500 white, so let's get them cracked. There we have those parts done. I also remembered a bit that needed doing, so I quickly cleaned it up and primed it. Next up, some hairy stick work. I'm using Tamiya X14 Sky Blue to do the metal trim braces for the tail. So let's get those sorted. I also did the horns in Tamiya Desert Yellow XF59 and the prop hub and radio antenna in Vallejo 71.062 aluminium. Anywho, this seems like as good a place as any to end, so thank you for watching episode 19. If you want to see what happens in episode 20, then please subscribe to my channel, help it grow, like the video, leave a comment and ring my bell. Remember folks, stay safe. Keep on modelling.